Students, we will discuss the other part of this, that is the dispersion without deviation. So dispersion without deviation. That means dispersion will occur, deviation will not occur. So there is dispersion but no deviation. So we will have arrangement of two prisms again, but this time we have like this situation. This is one prism shaped like that. The other prism is shaped like this. This type of prism is taken. The rest remaining the same. Here A is the angle of prism and A prime is the angle of the other prism, which is made up of lead glass. This is made up of crown glass. The ray of white light goes straight obliquely, falls on this side of the prism and gets dispersed. If it is not there, in the absence of this, this would have gone straight like that. But dispersion will occur. So I will say like that. This is red and this is violet. Afterwards, the other prism kept inverted will do the opposite work. It produces dispersion in clockwise sense, that will produce dispersion in anti-clockwise sense or negative sense. This is in positive sense, that is in negative sense. So depending on the dispersive power, if this is dispersive power is omega and its dispersive power is omega prime, if omega prime is greater than omega, then the net dispersion will be negative. Now let me draw this as go like that. This goes like this, and the yellow one goes something like that. So I could not draw it properly. The yellow one should have followed this direction, in fact. So they follow this direction. So this direction should be yellow one. Okay. So I'll put this as yellow. And this is my, this is yellow, this is my red color. Sorry, violet color. So this is the violet, this is the yellow, this is the red part. This one. Now, what I would say is that this yellow line and this are in the same direction, so there is no deviation. There is a lateral displacement, but in fact, there is no deviation. There is lateral shift, but there is no angular deviation. A person moving along this line and a person moving on this line, there is no angular deviation, there is a lateral shift. So, when you talk about no deviation, that means we are talking about the no deviation of a yellow color. This is for yellow color, because when dispersion is there, the different colors will be dispersed in different directions. So, in different directions, they will get dispersed according to the original direction. This is also being deviated. This is also being deviated. There is only one ray that is not being deviated. And we are concerned with that deviation of that color, no deviation of yellow colors. So this is basically the diagram, and the rest thing that we used to have the terminology in the previous video, we discussed that that omega is for angular dispersive power for first prism, this is for second prism, angular prism, first prism, angular prism, second prism, and delta y, delta v, delta v, delta r. Now, the physics part of this is the condition of this no deviation. We'll first discuss about this. No deviation. No deviation. The deviation is delta deviation of no deviation of which color? Yellow color. That means the deviation produced by Y. That is the first prism, and the deviation produced by the second prism should be equal in terms of their magnitude. Obviously, they are negative because one is clockwise, another is anticlockwise. So, magnitude wise, they must be same. Okay, so I will use this on delta y, you know, that is A into mu y minus 1. This is into mu y dash minus 1. This will be right. This is in one equation. So let's just write that the magnitude part is same. I may not write negative over here. Okay, we can just write plus, no problem with that. Okay, because we know that this is negative, this is positive. You can take magnitude as positive. Okay, we are concerned with the magnitude of this in the expression. So again, for dispersion, net dispersion, because the dispersion is occurring, finally the rays are coming out with different colors. That means the white light is being dispersed. Net dispersion is dispersion produced by first is delta V minus delta R, and the dispersion produced by the second is delta V dash minus delta R dash. This is the net dispersion produced. Though one in a clockwise, another in anticlockwise sense, but still this is true. So therefore, this we can write as, this part I can write as A into mu V minus mu R, and this I can write as A dash mu V dash minus mu R dash. This part we can write. Again, our aim is to write the net dispersion that is produced, that is in terms of omega and omega dash. So I'll put that condition of equation 1, which is this, in place of A dash. I can substitute this divided by this, that is also possible. So I'll do that, or I'll take this common out and whatever. So in place of, because A into mu y minus 1 is A dash into minus 1. So A dash is this divided by dash minus 1. This I can substitute here, or I can write A dash by A, no problem with that. I can write A dash by A is this, which is to be put here. If that is possible, if I take A common out, then what you have, mu v minus mu r. So A is taken out, mu v minus mu r plus A dash upon A there is no A over here, so A is multiplied, A is divided, then the A is taken out. Now this part is here, A is substituted here, then what will get? Why this is being done? This is being done to have a relations of this whatever net deviation that you are producing in terms of omega. Okay, just trying to write that. This is A mu v now this comes to this side. Okay, this comes to this side, mu, this again I will take a mu y minus 1 common, then what will happen? There is no mu y minus 1 here, so that will be divided. This is minus 1 plus, think of it as divided as minus 1. And so net dispersion, one is positive, one is negative, so the counterpoint is so there should be negative here with proper sign. This will be negative because ultimately the dispersion produced by the first prism and the second prism, which is kept inverted, produced by this prism and the other prism, which is like that, will be anticlockwise n. So proper sign with this, a into mu minus 1 net dispersion for of yellow color is minus 1 mu v minus mu r by this is omega and this is minus, this is omega dash. This is what, this is horribly delta y omega minus omega dash. Net dispersion is this, net dispersion is this, because delta y is same as delta y dash, the angular deviation is same. So therefore you can write this or write this, it means the same thing. So this is the final condition. So you may drop this y, but you may remember that this is your y. So so this is the deviation of mean color. So this is delta into omega minus omega dash. So if omega dash is greater than omega, implies the net deviation is negative. Net dispersion is, net dispersion is negative. Okay. This arrangement is basically used in direct vision spectroscope. So this is a direct vision, this type of arrangement is called direct vision arrangement, and that type of arrangement is called achromatic combinations. This is direct vision combination where you have dispersion without deviation, and if I write side by side the conditions that I have obtained so far, so you can conclude that for deviation without dispersion, this condition is satisfied. The net deviation produced in achromatic combination of prism is delta y into 1 minus omega upon omega dash. This is the net deviation. This is the net deviation, and for no dispersion, this condition should be satisfied. Delta y upon delta y dash is omega dash upon omega. Okay, and for this case, the net dispersion is delta y omega dash. Okay, so you must know, keep in mind as a formula to be used. Okay, these are the important formula you to use. Okay, thank you very much.